Today I'll walk you through how to make some bows. Keep watching! This is Brandy and this is Making It My Own DIYs. Alright, so we're going to start off with some wired ribbon. It's good to know wired ribbon is the thing to use when you want to make a bow that will stand out. Not a floppy bow, but one that's going to have some strength. So what I'm doing here is pretty easy. You're just going to take this ribbon and just fold it over on itself several times. Just like this. You can count how many times I'm doing it. And you just want to kind of make sure that the more loops that you put in there, the more folds you put in there, just know that's going to be a bigger bow, and the less loops, it's going to be a smaller bow. All right, I'm folding it in the center and I'm going to cut some notches in the side. I call this a notch bow, but different crafters call this different things. I did not create this originally. Okay, so I'm just going to slip a piece of twine right in the notches and pull it tight. You can use zip ties for this also. You can also use floral wire when you're making bows. That works really well too. Okay, so now you pull all of your pieces apart, just like this. Simple enough, right? You pull them all apart and you're gonna have this little, it almost looks like a little flower, doesn't it? You just keep fluffing and fluffing until you get the shape that you like. That wire is really gonna help. Okay, and so for a tail, I just folded another piece in half and I'm just gonna use some hot glue. And just whatever you're putting your bow on, you can use some glue to glue it on that surface, or you can actually put it on the back of your bow top. All right. Now we're going to take some more wired ribbon. The other bow that was before, we used about 8 inches loops on that one. And on this one, it looks like we're going to be using about 18 inches. We're going to fold it over like the breast cancer awareness. And then you're just going to make sure that your tails are about the same size, pinch it in the middle and walk it the top toward the bottom so it all meets up in the center. I'm just making sure that I didn't press anything down that needs to be poofed out, and holding it firmly with my other hand. All right, so you can take a piece of jute or whatever you want to tie this with and just tie it down. And this is going to be pretty much the same process with the next 3 pieces, but this is like a layered bow to give you some ideas if you want to do something that's a little more bulky but still kind of a simple look. Now this is just some satin ribbon I had. This is not wired. If you make small bows with this, it's fine. It's absolutely fine. And this is kind of a cottagey piece that I'm doing here, so I think this style works really well with that. I'm just going to press it down and use that same piece and just pull it right on there. Just tie that knot right on top of that, and we're going to leave it there because we're going to add a little bit more. And when you use jute, you can kind of adjust a little bit more. If you use a zip tie, that's really going to hold it tight and you don't have a lot of room to move things around. So this little piece of ribbon here is wired, and so I'm going to sit it on top. That'll let me have the option of giving it a little height if I kind of want to poof it out a little bit, because the tendency of that satin no wired ribbon is to kind of lay flat. But it's holding its shape pretty well there, so that's a good thing. And then of course you want to move the little loops of the bows around so that each one of them can be seen. You know, whichever way you want to do it. Again, with the wire, you're going to have a little more ability to change the way things look than you will with the satin ribbon. And then you can either slant cut the ends of your ribbon or you can dovetail them, whichever way you want. You always have options and it can give each one of your bows a different look. So if you make the same types of bows all the time, you can still make them look different, especially when you use different types of fabrics and different types of, you know, ribbon textures. All right, so on this next bow, I'm going to make some tails that are about 10 inches long, so you can see me using my ruler here. I'm just going to pinch that ribbon right where that's at, and I'm going to make a loop. And because this fabric on this ribbon is printed on both sides, you don't necessarily have to twist it. We're going to use 12-inch pieces, which are going to make 6-inch loops, right? Because when you fold it over, it makes a 6-inch loop. So you can see very easily here, there's 6 inches on either side. If you have a bow maker, this is a very simple bow to do on a bow maker, but this is really easy to just do in your hand if you don't have a ribbon that's super thick and it needs to be wired. So I'm just kind of measuring now with my hands and counting that I have 2 loops on each side. I'm going to clamp it together in the middle while I move on to the next section. Again, I'm going to go to the 10-inch, pinch it, twist it, because this ribbon is printed on one side and not on the other. Now we're going to go down to 5 inches. So you're going to have a 10-inch piece and you're going to make 5-inch loops, twisting it into the center as you go so that you have your pretty side up. You can see there, that's 5 inches. And we're going to layer that right on top. We're only going to do 2 loops on that bow. You can do as many as you like though. Same process here. This is a sheer ribbon, which I thought would be nice to kind of add. And we're going to put 5 inches on this one as well. And then I'm going to layer that right on top. Now it does have wire, the sheer ribbon does, but it doesn't give a lot of body to the bow. But I just want you to see that you can mix your textures. So I have a cotton plaid underneath, I have a burlap with the dots, and then the sheer on the top. It does make a beautiful bow though. You can dovetail or finish off your ends however you choose. And you're left with this pretty little bow. It's actually a pretty big bow. Be sure you fluff it out. I don't know if I've mentioned that yet, but a lot of what really makes your bow look gorgeous is fluffing the bow out, which means pulling up and making those loops round and full. Don't leave anything laying flat and try to separate your textures. Okay, well, we're on to the next bow. I have a variety of ribbons here, different textures. This is like a, almost like a, maybe a satin type ribbon, but it's wired. So we're gonna make an 18-inch cut right here. And I'm just going to dovetail my ends. You can wait to the end to do this, or you can do it before. This does not matter one bit. And I change it up depending on what mood I'm in. I just kind of go with the flow when I get into my crafting. You know how it goes. So then we'll be folding that piece over, and we're just going to pinch this one right in the middle. And we're going to do this with all of our pieces of ribbon that we choose. So here's some green burlap that came from Dollar Tree. Love this ribbon. This is a very, very quality ribbon from Dollar Tree. I'm just going to pinch it in the middle, and I'm going to hold it between my fingers just like this. This is a very thick ribbon that I got at the thrift store, so it takes a little more work for my little bitty hands, but I get it in there. I wear a size 5 ring, if that gives anybody an idea of my hand size. So yeah, Bowmaker is a big helper for me, but I like to show people options that do not require a Bowmaker in case you don't have one. Okay, so we're just going to continue along, and you can see that I'm kind of separating out my little pieces, trying to make sure that I don't have two of the same color in the same area. I want to mix up those patterns because it really makes a pretty presentation with your bow when you have, you know, a little bit all over the place. So you can see, if I was to put it right there, no, we don't want those two burlaps together, so I'm going to move it to the other side, and that looks better. And then the last piece of my little wired ribbon, just like that. And I will have playlists. I have lots of playlists that you can watch with these videos, so you can see the entire video if you are interested in the crafts that I make with these bows. So this one, I'm going to use a zip tie. I'm not going to let go with my hand at all on the other side. I'm going to use one hand to do all of this. You're going to put that tie on there, tighten it up a little bit. You can move things around and then really cinch it down tightly. that's going to hold this bow really well. If you're doing this bow, which is referred to as a funky bow, you really have got to use something that's going to hold, because there's a lot of fluffing involved. And so a zip tie is going to hold everything so tight for you that you're just going to, it's going to be easier for you to work with it without the fear of everything falling apart, because there's nothing worse than a knot slipping on a piece of jute on a bow that you've worked so hard to create. So we turn it over and we're going to fluff it out and put our printed side away from us so that it will be up when you flip the bow over. Separate everything just like that. Nice. Turn it over and fluff it back up. Hey, if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, I would love to have you as a member. I'm working on getting to 10,000 subscribers by 2022, and I would love to have you as part of the channel growth. You won't regret it. Okay, on to the next one. This is another bow that we're just going to fold over, over and over, and this is about 8 inches of fabric. Well, it's a fabric ribbon, I'll put it that way, but it is wired. I'm just going to fold it in half and lay it down, and I'm going to go onto this Dollar Tree ribbon that I have that I didn't think I would use, but I think it looks good. I think it looks good with the project that I'm doing. So I'm just going to count my loops here, and remember, each loop is going to be a loop on your bow, so that's how you can know how big you want to make it. I'm going to be cutting down a piece of this so that I can tie this around the middle, because that's an option also. So you got jute, we've done jute, we've done floral wire, we've talked about zip ties, and now you can actually use a piece of ribbon to tie around the center if you would like to do it that way. So I'm just gonna make kind of like a bow tie with each one of these, pinch my pattern one on top, and then we're gonna take a zip tie around the center, and then we'll overlay another piece of ribbon on top. And you won't be able to see that, and the center of it will look like it's just tied with a regular ribbon. So you could see how tight I tried to make that bow, and then I just clipped it off. Then I'm gonna pull out, start on the bottom, pull out your bottom layers, and then go up to the upper layer and then start fluffing that one out. I always like to see what I have. You know, after you get it on your project, you're gonna have to fluff it again. And then once you hang it, your project, wherever you want to hang it, you'll probably fluff it again, but that's okay. I mean, that's part of it if you want to make beautiful bows and you want to make, you know, unique pieces. Okay, so for the tails, I'm using about 18 inches. This is what I had left of this one, and I'm just going to dovetail those, and then you do the same thing with the red, that other piece of ribbon. Layer them up, and then we'll use those as the tails. I'm just measuring to get them about the same size. Pinch in the middle, and then I'm going to place it down in the middle of that ribbon that I used to tie it onto the surface that I'm working with. But if you didn't have a surface to tie it on, you can just tie this right onto the back of your bow. So you can use these bows to put on gifts too. You can use them as gift toppers. You can use them as little decorative pieces, or, you know, whatever for your stockings. You can use them on garland. Anything you want. These are really pretty bows. So I thought my bow needed a little something extra just to lighten it up a tad. I'm not for all of the super dark stuff. I needed a little brightness in there, and I love this ribbon. So I'm just going to do the same thing. I'm folding over and over, but this is 5 inches. I'm going to cut it off, and I'm just going to tie it with a little piece of jute right in the middle. And we're going to layer this little cutie right over the top. I just felt like it needed something else. And you'll see, it makes a difference. It gives it a little pop that I really like. So I'm gonna pull them out. And for a small ribbon, the wire and the shape of this ribbon is fantastic. I got it from Big Lots on clearance last year, so I hope to find something with the same strength this year. And there's only 4 little loops in this one. But look how cute that is right in the top. And using decorative ribbon that is going to match something that you're working on is really going to set your bow and that project off. It kind of, I don't know, plays against each other. Okay, so now we're going to make a tiny bow. And this little bitty bow. A lot of people use like the little fork bows or the finger bows. That's something I've never really gotten into just because I haven't tried it, because I've always done things, you know, this way. Just looping it over, just like the bigger bow, the breast cancer awareness little shape, and then pressing it down in the center. And then I just sliced this ribbon, took the edge off of it. It wasn't centered anyway. And I'm just going to use it, try to get my center right, and then tie it tightly in the middle with that strip. It frays a little bit, but I'm not worried about that. That's not a problem. And then I'm just going to cut these at an angle because it's such a small bow. Okay, now it's a little messy bow. These are cute bows. These are fun bows to do because you can really put a lot of different textures. You can even use raffia. You can use jute, any type of cording, anything that you want in these. Right now I'm using 4-inch pieces of ribbon, and I'm just going to use two of each pattern that I choose. And I did put the striped ones away for the other project that I did with this. And I really like this. I like these colors together, the polka dots, the solid colors, the little rickrack in there is really cute. I think you could probably even use pom-pom trim if you wanted to in these bows. And then I'm going to cut a piece of my, oh yeah, my Frosty the Snowman ribbon. He's got a wire, but it doesn't really matter for this. It doesn't matter. Okay, so you're just going to layer those, and I'm just kind of doing a pattern of X's right over the top of the big bow in the back. You don't have to use a bigger piece of ribbon in the back. You can use all small diameters, and in other videos that I have, I'll try to do another bow video for you guys soon, and you'll see how many options you have with this. Okay, so I'm just showing you here, I have a bread tie. It's either a bread tie or a tie that came off of a piece of Christmas decoration. I'm not sure because I used to not throw a thing away. I'm getting better. But yeah. So I'm just using this because it's wired. So, you know, pretty much the same thing as a piece of floral wire. And you're just going to twist that up in the middle tightly. And that's going to hold it together for you. Now I'm going to dovetail my ends because this is going to give it the shape of a bow. Cute. I love that ribbon. I think that ribbon came from Dollar General last year with a snowman. Beautiful. Y'all don't sleep on Dollar General for bows. Well, I mean for ribbons and for crafting supplies and for decor. They really have some nice stuff. As well as Dollar Tree. You can hear me referring to a lot of things in my videos as Dollar Tree items because I love to save money where I can without, you know, skimping on quality. So I like to share that with y'all too. So now I'm just cutting these other ones at a slant. And that's how it looks. You just fluff it around by pulling them out so that you can see each little layer. And then put it where you want to put it. Next one, super easy. This is just a shoelace bow. And we're going to do this with jute so that you have some options for farmhouse and rustic type things that are smaller projects. I'm cutting 4 pieces of equal pieces of jute, and they're about 12 inches long. Now I'm just going to make 2 little loops, wrap the loop around, tuck it in the hole, and then pull it out. Simple. Simple, simple. But some people don't know how to do this, so I'm showing you what you can do. You can do it with one, you can do it with a bunch of ribbon, you can do it with as many pieces of cording as you want. Alright, on to the next one. These are wired ribbons. They are not the best of quality. I'm not even sure where I got that red and that polka dot one from. Not sure. Probably from the thrift store. And then this one actually came from Dollar Tree. This is a scrap that I had, and I'm just pulling the edges off because I took the wire piece, the wire edge off, and I'm just trying to fray it just a little bit because I like the look. And you can do this or not, or you can just use a piece of 1-inch ribbon that matches. Mix your patterns. It really makes a pretty look too. Mix your patterns, mix your colors, mix your textures. It makes a very interesting bow, and it's going to make it something that is unique and not like something everybody else has or everybody else is doing. You know, and that's what brings us joy, looking at something that we know we accomplished on our own and going, wow, that really looks good. Something you can be proud of. That's what it's all about. So I'm just going to take that, wrap it around a few times, and then hot glue it down. Once it's dry, I'll just trim that off, and then it's ready to go. You can put it on whatever piece you want. Looks kind of like a little bow tie, but it has no tails on it, so it's a tailless bow. Okay, so this is another funky bow. I want to be sure that you guys understand how to make these bows because they are beautiful and they make such a big impact. Now what I have here is about, I'm going to say, 18 inches to 2 feet of ribbon. Because I had to use a scrap based on how much of that rust colored ribbon I had left. And I didn't want to lose the opportunity of using it because I knew it would be great in this wreath. So now I'm just stacking these up. They're all the same diameter. I have, I think, one pattern and the rest are solid colors. Nope, two patterns. There we go. I've got another one. The plaid underneath came from Dollar Tree, and I absolutely love it. It's one of my favorite fall ribbons they put out. And then this one I got at the thrift store. Probably came from Hobby Lobby, Michaels, Joann's, something like that. But be sure you look at your thrift stores for stuff like this. And now we're just going to go about, I think on this one I went about 4 inches down so that we'd have a longer tail. And I'm going to pinch it, put it in my hand. I'm going to hold it tightly in my right hand. I am right-handed. And I'm going to pinch it up, put it in my hand. The reason you see me pulling those loops apart is because I'm trying to get an idea that they are the same height. I want to make sure that they're about the same size. So that's what I do. I kind of pull, fluff them out a little bit so I can see, just like that, you can see. And then I'm going to continue with kind of mixing up my patterns. I only had one little piece of that rust-colored ribbon left. It's beautiful. And like I said, those Dollar Tree ribbons, those particular ones, the green and all of those, were really good ribbon. That one was thrifted also. And then this one is from Dollar Tree, and you can get it pretty much year-round. I do recommend it. I love it. It works very good in lots of projects, and it's a neutral color, so it's perfect. Plus, if you don't know me, then one thing you should know, or if you haven't figured it out by looking at this video so far, is that I really love rustic decor. Love it so much. Love the earthy tones. Love the colors. And so you'll see a lot of that in my videos. All right, so just squished them together, and yes, it looks like they are all the same height. Now I can really tighten up that zip tie. Then I'm going to trim it off and start looking at the top of my bow. Now, if you want to, you can start by fluffing the bottom of your bow out. It doesn't matter. Whichever way you want to do it. I was just pulling my layers apart. Again, this is wired ribbon. It gives you the ability to reposition it. So, like those patterned ribbons there, they were easy to flip over so that I would have the pretty side up. And you can accomplish that by flipping it down. And now I'm just going to turn it over and flick and pull and twist and see what wants to go where. And then you can see I separated my colors. I love making bows. Love them, love them. And I hope that by the end of this video, you're not still afraid of doing bows. You can so do these bows. And I've put some really easy ones, some simple ones in here for you because I don't want anybody to watch this video and be discouraged. You can do this. Play this video over and over. Put it on pause. Go grab your ribbon. Go get your, you know, whatever and do it along with me. You can watch this video a billion times if you want to. You can put it in slow motion, whatever it takes. You can do this. I know you can do it. So now I'm just kind of bending up the wires for the tails on the bottom because these are longer tails. And you can do that by just putting your fingers on them and rolling them outward. And then you can just, you know, kind of flex them with your hand like that. Kind of flick them up and they'll stay where they need to be. And they're so pretty. Love the colors in this bow. So once you get it on your project, then you can look at it and decide if you want to add extra tails. And this is just a piece of folded over, and I think it's about 12 inches that I have just glued right into the base of the bow. Alright, so here's another beauty. This ribbon is so thick. If you don't have Southern Living ribbon, and you want like a super thick ribbon, here she goes. This is a huge bow. This one is about, well, it's huge for me anyway. This is about 10 inches here. And I've looped it over on itself several times. And remember what I said, it's gonna be a loop for each one of those. It's going to be a fold for each loop, let's put it that way. On each end, when you count, you'll see that. Gonna go on to another ribbon that coordinates, and I think this one is very pretty. This one I got at the thrift store. I pulled it off of a, I think it was on another wreath or something, and I pulled it off and I brought it home. You can do that at the Goodwill bins. You can do that. Okay, so flip it over, put the folds downward. I'm gonna take this ribbon next, and this one, I've seen something similar to this at either Michael's or Hobby Lobby in the wedding section, but you know I got mine at the thrift store by now. So, okay, so I'm just folding half. You can see, fold in half, find your center, and then use your scissors or your cutters, whatever you need to use here, depending on the type of ribbon you have, and cut through that outside and just slightly into the inside. You don't want to go too far, your ribbon will fall apart, and that won't be good. So just, you can see, I kind of go until I feel my scissors cut through the wire, and then I stop. And then for this big boy, I had to use my cutters. It is so thick, so thick. All right, so I'm gonna flip it over because I want the tail to be under each one of them. Flipped them all over. So now that loose end is on the bottom. I'm gonna take a zip tie, and I really worried about this zip tie. I didn't think it would be big enough, but it worked. It worked. So I'm gonna take that zip tie, and I'm going to kind of finagle it around in those little slits, and then pull it tight. Okay, now, if you're using a real thick ribbon, you definitely need to use that little notching method because the fabric on these ribbons is so incredibly thick. They don't have a lot of flexibility, I guess is a good word for it. So just keep that in mind. You might want to notch the bigger bows. Gonna start on the bottom and start pulling those out, and I can pull them hard because I know I've got that zip tie on there and it's gonna hold it tight for me. So I'm pulling out and away with all of my little pieces. Doing that is gonna make that fabric at the little slice points kind of lock into place. So when you pull it to the side and twist, it kind of locks it over there. Now, this ribbon was really flimsy, not very good quality, so I'm just cutting off those little pieces there. You can do that. Those were the little free ends, and they just weren't worth keeping. But with this thicker burlap, it's really pretty, and I want these to show, so I'm just going to cut those just like that in a little dovetail. And they look very pretty like that, I think. I'm going to do the same thing with this thicker one on the bottom and use that as part of the bow, flexing that out so that you can see it. And I'm just trying to make a circular shape here with my bow. And if you keep fluffing, you can get there if you have enough little loops in there. So you can see how much fluffing I do. Fluff and fluff and fluff and fluff. But it's important because see what you end up with is something that's really pretty. Now this bow doesn't have tails and I need tails on this particular project. So I'm just going to take 18 inches of this one, and I'm going to use 18 inches of the snowflake, and then I'm going to use the remainder of the one with the little pearl edge. Doesn't matter that they're not the same length. I'm going to pinch those, give them a little twist, and once you get it all secured, you can secure it to the bottom of your bow with some hot glue or some more wire. Thank you so much for stopping by. I hope you learned a little something today, and I'll see you again soon. Bye!